Hello, welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to explain how to create an add-in in Excel by using C#. Through this add-in, I would like to print the numbers on Excel worksheet. Click on File, New, Create New Project, under Office or SharePoint, expand Office or SharePoint, click on Office Addins, assign name as per our requirement, select the folder of print. Now I am saving this add-in in print folder, which exists on desktop. Here from the available options, I am selecting VSTO add-in. Click on OK. On generator screen, we can find two functions, startup and shutdown. Here I want to add a new item to the ribbon. Right click on project, add new item. I am selecting the ribbon, click on add button. Now application created a new ribbon, click on tab addins, change the label. Click on group 1. Now I am changing the label. Now I want to add new button. Click on toolbox. From Office Ribbon Controls, select a button, now I inserted a button here. I am changing the label for button. Now let us cross check with Excel. Click on start. Now we can find new add-in with the name of tricks12345. There under print numbers group, you can find the click here button. My next step is, when I click on click here button, I want to display a form with a text box on the screen. Let us go to Visual Studio. Now I am adding new form. Right click on Project, click on Add, Windows Form, select Windows Form, click on Add. Now application created Form 1, change the text in Properties window. Now I have changed the text of the form. My next step is, we add the text box to this form. Select the text box. After that, I am adding a button. Resize the form as per our requirement. Now we need to write the code to display the form when we click on this button. Here under ribbon1.cs, I am writing the code. Select the form 1. This is object variable. Now application has to show the form on screen. I am using show method. Now let us cross check with Excel. Now it is working fine. When I click here, form is displaying on screen. My next step is write the code to print the numbers. When I click on this button, numbers has to print from 1 to max number which is mentioned in text box. Double click on button. Here I am using Microsoft.Office.Indrop.Excel using Excel is equal to Microsoft.Office.Indrop.Excel. Here I am printing the numbers in Addin workbook itself instead of creating new workbook. Excel dot worksheet, SH is the variable, is equal to globals dot this Addin dot application dot. Worksheets. Sheet 1, as I want to print the numbers on sheet 1. Using activating the sheet 1. Here I am defining two variables. int r, int represents to integer, r is variable. Int max, max is equal to int dot parse textbox 1 dot text. This dot close, I am closing the form. Now I am writing the for loop. For r is equal to 1, I want to print the numbers from 1. R is less than or equal to max. SH dot treat variable. I am using cells property. For column, I am mentioning first, as I want to print the numbers in first column. Dot value is equal to r. For each and every iteration, I would like to increase the loop value with 1. Now let us cross check with Excel. Click on start. Here I am mentioning 5. Click on button. No numbers have been printed on column 1. An application thrown message box also on screen. I want to print numbers up to 11. I want to print numbers up to 150. Here, I want to clear the existing data before printing the new result set. To implement that, I am using clear method to erase the existing data, which is preceded by current region property. Now let us see. SH dot range. A1. As a result, it's starting from range A1 dot current region dot clear. Now let us classic with the Excel. First, I am printing numbers up to 5. Next, I want to print numbers up to 3. Now it is removing existing data before printing new result set. Likewise, we can create an add-in to print the numbers on add-in workbook itself. Hope this video is useful to everyone. Thanks for watching.